You'll have to channel him. So yeah. Do we have questions or discussions on open-ended AI, open value networks, open minds, or any vaguely related topics? All right. Was that one working?
Ooh.
This is a question to Diego. When I see the strong opposition of governments against Bitcoin,
that there was the microphone.
Yes, sir.
Closer.
Yeah,
okay. When I see the strong opposition of against Bitcoin, especially from governments, so that no country adopted and there's so much false press about Bitcoin, how it finances Al-Qaeda, etc., why Huala has existed for hundreds of years. So how do you think this commons-based productivity or basically what you presented would if it would spread, it would also cause the same opposition, so effectively this is not only productivity, but eventually it may lead to creation of some way of independent trans-border government or trans-border society. So how you think that would come?
Well, the problem of the regulation is something that we are also talking about a lot. And for example, we are talking with people from Harvard, the Benckler Institute, the Benckler Center, and for example, Primavera Di Filippi, who is working about the governance and the legal issues of blockchain technologies. So they are trying to push some regulatory issues in order to understand how to regulate this. And for example, in the case of Bitcoin, there are some cases of drug, for example, the Silk Road shop online and all these problems. But now we are trying to move to different cryptocurrencies, which are also kind of managed by the community. For example, the Faircoin movement, which is a government, the coin itself is governed by cooperatives democratically. So there's different ways to track the transactions and to avoid this way to money laundering and this kind of issue. So I think it's a matter of time to, we have to wait to see what happens.
Anyone else? Oh, everybody always says words of wisdom.
Can you compare your ideas about peer-to-peer governance versus direct democracy, and how do you think the future will unfold with regards to that? Will people prefer such governance systems over more traditional structures?
Well, I think that we have a crisis of representation currently, no, around the traditional government systems, in which there's not a connection with people and the traditional government. But for example, there are some interesting experiments going on. The Bit Nation project, do you know it? They are trying to build up a whole nation, all the governance systems that you need, even to pay taxes, they are trying to implement that on the blockchain. So I think a lot of interesting things are coming up.
Influencing the evolution of open-ended intelligence?
Actually, we postponed thinking about it. We have some ideas about the implementations, but actually we try to reach a place where we understand better the principles and then go into implementation. And actually the implementation side, we have in mind all sorts of evolutionary processes, because there is a lot of place for contingency, which is not part of an organized or a democratize the way of developing applications, but this is still a work in progress. But we definitely have some ideas about implementation. It's not only, we don't believe in just the theoretical stuff floating all around without any ability to give some extra.
Right.
I hope it answers the question.
Yes. All right, we may then proceed with the final workshop on the theme of social and economic implications of AGI. And really my, you know, we've done workshops